Should schools in the United States follow the CDC recommendations or not? Dr. Redfield has clearly said these are recommendations and every situation is going to look slightly different. And the key for education leaders, and these are smart people who can figure things out. The CDC guidelines are just that, meant to be flexible and meant to be applied as appropriate for the situation.
You're asking students to go back. So why do you not have guidance on what a school should do just weeks before you want those schools to reopen? And what happens if it faces an outbreak?
You know, there's really good examples that have been utilized in the private sector and elsewhere, also with frontline workers and hospitals. And all of that data and all of that information and all of those examples can be referenced leaders.
But I'm not hearing a plan from the Department of Education. Do you have a plan
for what students and what schools should do? So, schools should do what's right on the ground at that time for their students and for their situation.
All right, John Ladner is a high school teacher in Denton, Texas, so this is not just some academic debate for him. Your state right now is seeing a sustained market jump in infections, and yet state education leaders are moving ahead right now with plans to reopen schools next month, even though parents in your district can opt out to have schooling online. I know that you wrote a Facebook post about why you think schools should be all online in the fall. Tell us how, tell us why you think that is, and also how you came to this decision, even as, you know, we know, I think everyone wants kids back in school, so we're negotiating, we're balancing these things. Tell us about that.
Well, I definitely believe that kids learn better in the classroom. I teach better in the classroom, but the fact of the matter is we're becoming one of the epicenters of the virus right now. I know a lot of people are probably looking at this past spring and saying that, you know, we don't necessarily want a repetition of that. However, you got to understand that we turned on a dime there. You know, we, with no preparation, with no warning, you know, we had to rework everything about what we do just from the ground up. And the fact that, you know, Governor Greg Abbott, it took as long as he did to declare that schools would be closed, it put our districts in an additional bind where they couldn't make decisions about like how grades would work for the remainder of the semester, for example. And it's hard to maintain student accountability without that sort of thing in place. I mean, that's part of just how school works. And so if we make the commitment now, like seeing just how sharp the rise in cases is, if we make the commitment now to prepare for online instruction in the fall, we can be much more prepared to do so.
So do you feel like you have that? Do you feel like there's a plan for how you do this?
Well, right now, the plan from the Texas Education Agency is for all schools to offer face-to-face instruction for a full academic schedule. And that's insane. Right now, teachers are scared. Teachers are going out there writing their wills. 1 in 5 teachers in Texas right now is considering leaving the profession. Personally, I know teachers who are older than I am who are choosing to retire early, teachers who are younger than I am who are changing careers. And we're also talking about 2-income households who are deciding, you know what, we can make 1 income work for now. And that's the anxiety among teachers right now.
Yeah, look, my sister's a teacher and she's a single mom. So I'm wondering, what happens if she gets sick, right? When she goes back to school, who's going to take care of her if she gets sick? She has 2 kids. What does she do? So all of these teachers are trying to figure this out. These are the existential questions that you're dealing with that you haven't had to before. What do you think the threshold? So look, once those teachers who decide they're going to stay in the profession, they're going to go back into the classroom, they don't have a choice, they have to do it, they go back in, then do you have a sense of what the threshold is or the tolerance level is for an outbreak? Is it 1 sick kid? Is it 10? How do they do this?
I don't know the answer to that question specifically, but according to the TEA's new guidelines, schools are not going to be allowed to, school campuses will not be allowed to remain closed for longer than 5 consecutive days. And I mean, that's ignoring all of the facts about how this virus works.
So you've seen this story, right, that has come out of Arizona, where you had three teachers, right? They had a sort of a summer school virtual program for 2 weeks to help kids catch up. Obviously, there's remediation you have to be doing. That's something that you're going to be struggling with here in the near term, and maybe even longer than that. But they had it, so there were three teachers in a classroom, physically in a classroom. They were wearing masks. They were socially distancing. All of them, all three in one of those classrooms got COVID. One of them died. So you are looking at that example. I'm sure a number of other teachers are. Do you feel like your administration and the Texas health officials are?
The Texas Education Agency obviously is not. I know that my district, along with many other districts, they're trying to they've spent this summer trying to come up with plans where we can get, you know, some of our more vulnerable populations, our special ed populations, our children with early literacy levels, so we can get them into the classroom with much more distance. But the Texas Education Agency, they're not even giving us the freedom to do that.
Yeah, and you're indoors, right? This is the issue that we're seeing increasingly with the science. Indoors is the problem. And
can I just interject there?
Yeah.
Can I interject there? Indoors with windows that don't open and with air conditioning systems that frequently break down.
So nothing's changed since we were in school, I see, with the air conditioning, right? there's no discussion about how they are. I mean, look, it would be expensive to retrofit a classroom. It would be expensive to replace HVAC units, but you're not hearing anything about that.
Look, I don't think it's a surprise to anyone that teachers often buy their own supplies right now. That looks like is teachers building their own plexiglass shields for their desks.
Yeah, it's crazy. John, you are doing such important work, and you're in a bind, and you shouldn't have to figure out all these answers on your own. So thanks for telling us exactly what you're dealing with. We appreciate it.
Well, thank you so much.